Hello children, trigonometry is an important branch of mathematics. In fact, in trigonometry, we study the relationship between the sides and angles of right angle triangle. Today, we shall perform an activity to understand the meaning of trigonometric ratios. For that activity, the material required are circular board, rotating needle, set squares, colored strips, labeling slips, colored pen, and a ruler. Before going into trigonometric ratios, we shall see the properties of right angle triangle. Now, we take a right angle triangle. This is a right angle triangle. Here, the right angle is at angle B. So, angle C and angle A are acute angles and they are complement to each other. Means, angle A plus angle C is 90. We know that the side which is opposite to the right angle is hypotenuse. Here, we have three sides. If we consider acute angle A, with respect to the acute angle A, BC is opposite side. With respect to angle A, AB is adjacent side. If we consider angle C and with respect to the angle C, AB is opposite side and with respect to the angle C, BC is adjacent side. Children, we have three sides. So, we can have six combination of ratios. They are trigonometric ratios. Now, we recall those trigonometric ratios. Here we have triangle ABC and right angle is given at B. Now, we consider angle A as theta degrees. For that, the opposite side is BC and the adjacent side is AB. We know that sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse, means BC by AC, and cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is AB by AC, and tan theta is opposite side by adjacent side, BC by AB. Now, cosecant theta is hypotenuse by opposite side, means AC by BC, and secant theta is AC by AB, and cot theta is AB by BC. This we already know that. Now, we will understand the meaning of these trigonometric ratios using the circular board. Children, this is a circular board. Here we have a needle where we can fix this needle in the center and we can rotate this needle along the circle. On the circular board, you can see x axis and y axis. This is unit circle, means from here to here it is one unit. You can see, say this is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, 1.01. Similarly, on the y axis. Suppose if we take this as a radius and everywhere you can get one unit. Now, we place this needle like this, which is on the x axis. Here, you can see on this board, 0 to 360 degrees are given at the center and also along the circle. If I place the needle like this, it is 0 degrees. Now, if I move like this, then it will be between 0 to 90, means it is acute angle. If I exactly keep on y axis, then it makes 90 degrees, which is called right angle. If I increase further, it will be more than 90, then this angle is obtuse angle. If I exactly keep like this on the x axis, then it is a straight angle, exactly 180 degrees. If I further move more than 180, and this angle is called reflexive angle. If I keep the needle like this, it will be 270 degrees. Now, if I bring back onto the x axis, it is a complete angle 360 degrees. Now, I will make an angle of 30 degrees with this needle. So, if I keep like this, it is 30 degrees. Now, we will measure the distance of this point P horizontally and vertically. For that, we need set squares. Now, the point is P here. Now, I will put one of the set squares like this. The side coincides with this x axis. I will slide this set square along this x axis until it touches the point P here. Now, you can see that it touches the point. Now, from here to here, it is horizontal distance, and from here to here, it is vertical distance. Children, you can see that since it is unit circle, from here to here, it is 10 centimeters, means one unit they took it as 1 centimeters. Now, if I want to measure this horizontal distance, here it is 0, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8 and 0.85. Now, if I want to measure the vertical distance here, it is from 0 to 5, means it is 0.5 unit. Like that, we can measure the vertical distance as well as the horizontal distance. Now, by using this disc, we will understand the trigonometric ratios of sin theta and cos theta. Now, we will make an angle just like a P here, point P, and the vertical distance which touches here and this is the horizontal distance. Children, we know that sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. Now, here if we take this as O and this is M, then we got a right angle triangle OMP, where the right angle is at M. We have got a chart which represents the same. So, this is O, where the theta is given, this is the M and this is the P. Now, we want to find out the value of sin theta. Now, sin theta is opposite side PM by hypotenuse OP, that we write on a paper. Sin angle theta means sin theta equal to, here it is PM by OP, means opposite side by hypotenuse. Children, we know that since it is a unit circle, OP value is 1 unit, implies PM by 1 is equal to PM. So, the vertical distance PM represents sin theta. Now, we find the value of cos theta. We know that cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Here the adjacent side is OM by the hypotenuse OP, means OM by, since it is a unit circle, OP equal to 1, this is which is equal to OM. So, this horizontal distance gives us cos theta. Now, we find the value of sin 90 minus theta. Children, if you see this triangle, it is right angle here. If this is the theta, then this will be 90 minus theta. Now, we are considering the value of sin 90 minus theta means opposite side by hypotenuse, then it will be OM by OP. We know that OP is 1 implies OM by 1 is equal to OM. Children, you can see that here OM means cos theta implies sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. Similarly, we find cos 90 minus theta. Cos 90 minus theta means it is adjacent side by hypotenuse. Now, for this the adjacent side is PM and the hypotenuse is OP, which is equal to PM by OP equal to PM by 1 is equal to PM. Children, you can see that this PM is equal to sin theta in this particular triangle, implies cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta. Children, we have measured it for a particular angle. Now, we will take different angles and we will measure the sin theta and cos theta. Now, we measure the values of 30 degrees, 45 degrees and 60 degrees. For that, I will arrange this needle at exactly 30 degrees. You can see that it is at 30 degrees. Now, I want to measure this vertical distance as well as horizontal distance. For that, I am keeping this set square like this and slide along this until it reaches this point. Now, we measure the PM. PM means this is the vertical distance. It is exactly 5 centimeters, means it is 0.5 since it is a unit circle. So, the vertical distance which we kept as PM is 0.5 and the horizontal distance from here to here it is a 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.85 and it is 0.9. So, we can say it is 0.87. Children, we know that this vertical distance is sin theta. So, sin theta is 0.5 sin 30, which is equal to half, and this horizontal distance is cos theta, which is equal to 0.87. Now, we go for 45 degrees. For that, once again, we will keep this needle at 45 degrees. Now, we measure the vertical distance as well as the horizontal distance. Once again, I keep this set square and slide along this x axis and I will keep it here right now. Now, we measure this vertical distance. Vertical distance is here it is 0.7 and it is crossed. So, it is 0.71. So, the vertical distance is 0.71 and we measure this horizontal distance also. It is 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, it is bit crossed. So, the horizontal distance it crossed 0.7 means 0.71. So, the vertical distance which is sin theta is 0.71 and the horizontal distance is also 0.71. So, children, you can observe that at 45 degrees sin theta is equal to cos theta. Now, we calculate the value of sin 60 and cos 60 now. For that, we keep this needle at 60. Now, we measure the vertical distance and horizontal distance. Like that, I keep this set square and slide along this x axis which meets here. Now, we measure the vertical distance. This is here 0.8587 approximately. So, the vertical distance is 0.87. Children, you can see that here 8 and 5 and afterwards 7. So, since it is a unit circle, we got 0.87 and the horizontal distance exactly it is at 0.5, then we can write here 0.5, which is equal to 1 by 2. So, sin theta is 0.87 and cos theta means cos 60 is 0.5. Children, by using different kinds of angles, you can find the values of sin theta, cos theta with this, by using this unit circular board and the rotating needle. Children, we have seen all the trigonometric ratios by using this circular disc. You can use the circular disc for n number of degrees and you can verify the result. Hope you have understood.